Well, as far as my horses will allow, twixt now and the hour of supper.
Fail not our feast?
My lord, I will not.
We hear our bloody cousins are bestowed in England and in Ireland, not confessing their cruel parricide, filling their hearers with strange invention. But more of that tomorrow. Adieu. Farewell to the horse.
Aye.
Farewell, Banquo.
Go.
Farewell.
Fleance with you.
Aye, my good lord. Well, the time calls upon us.
I wish your horses a swifter, surer foot, and I do command you to their backs. Farewell.
Farewell.
Let every man be the master of his time. Till 7 at night, we'll keep society a sweeter welcome. And till supper time, we'll keep ourselves alone. God be with you. To be thus is nothing but to be safely thus. Our fears in Banquo stick deep. And in his royalty of nature reigns which would be feared. 'Tis much he dares. And to that dauntless temper of his mind, he hath a wisdom that does guide his valor to act in safety. There's none but he whose being I do fear. And under him my genius is rebuked, as it is said was Mark Antony's by Caesar. He chid the sisters when they first put the name of king upon me and bade them speak to him. Then, prophet-like, they hailed him father to a line of kings. Upon my head they placed a fruitless crown and put a barren scepter in my gripe. Thence to be wretched by an unlineal hand. No son of mine succeeding. If it be so, for Banquo's issue have I fouled my mind. For them, the gracious Duncan have I murdered. Put runcorns in the vessel of my peace, only for them. Mine eternal jewel, given the common enemy of man, to make them kings, the seed of Banquo kings. Rather than so, come fate unto the list, and champion me to utterest. Who's there?